Hey, this must be Hoyt.
All my life, want to fight about it?
No, Hoyt, John Boy Billy here.
Hey, how you doing, boy?
All right, my man. Hey, listen, we've been getting all kinds of calls asking, where you and Delbert been lately?
We've been right here at the house.
No, I mean, why you hadn't been on the radio with us?
Oh, well, we've been kind of busy here. You know, we've had us a house guest for the last few weeks.
Who's that?
Debert's daddy. You remember Reed?
Yeah.
Yeah, he's been staying with us.
Uh-huh. Well, how's old Reed doing?
Not too good. Been having trouble with wife number 5.
My goodness, what's wrong?
Well, she threw him out a couple weeks ago.
Uh-huh.
It seemed he used one of her new kids on the block t-shirts when he was changing oil in his truck one Saturday.
I see Reed still likes them young.
Oh, you might say that. So anyway, last night we were sitting around having a beer or 12. Reed starts getting nostalgic. You know, he started telling stories about the big one again.
Telling stories about back when it's in World War II.
No, he was telling stories about the big one. That'd be Bernice. I believe she was wife number 3.
Oh.
Well, now that you mention it, Reed did tell one or two about World War II last night.
Right.
He had a terrible time. Scarred him for life.
For life, huh?
Oh, yeah. Reed was a crazy vet back when Rambo was running around with holes in the ass of his britches. I mean, Reed got messed up bad back when he was with the paratroopers.
What happened? Did a shoot not open or something?
No, it was this real ugly incident with his drill sergeant at jump school.
Mm.
He was telling us about it last night. Seems that Reed's sergeant was this big, black, ugly-looking dude. In fact, Reed says he was a lot like Mr. T, except he didn't have quite as sunny a disposition. You know? Yeah, they went through the classroom portion of the jump school, and it finally come time for the first jump.
Uh-huh.
Well, Reed was the last one to make the jump.
Uh-huh.
I mean, everybody else had done left the plane.
Yeah.
It was just Reed and the sergeant there. So Reed walks up to the door, looks out, and says, "I can't do it." And the sergeant says, "Boy, you going at that door?" And Reed says, "No way, Sarge." So the sergeant picks him up and tries to throw him out the door.
Ooh.
And Reed kind of wedges himself in the hatch, you know, kind of spread eagled.
Uh-huh.
And the sergeant says, "Jump, boy, now." And so Reed says, "No way, I ain't jumping." So this big, ugly sergeant unbuckles his britches,
Ooh. Drops
them to his knees,
Ooh. And
says, "Boy, if you don't go out that door, I'm going to, let me see if I can clean this up here." He said, "I'm going to take my manhood
Ooh. And
stick it right there where the sun don't shine."
My goodness.
Ooh. So about this time, Deborah turns to Reed and said, "Daddy, did you jump?" And Reed says, "Yeah, a little bit."
Oh, me!
That's what Reed said. And that, of course, that was followed by a long string of unsuccessful interpersonal relationships.
I guess.
Hey, listen, I got to run here. Me and Deborah's helping Reed find a job.
Oh, what's he looking for?
Well, we was talking on Pat McCrory,
uh-huh,
over on City Council.
Yeah.
He says there might be some cab driver jobs coming open pretty soon.
Yeah.
So maybe we can get him one of them. Hey, you going to see Goober later on?
Yeah.
Well, you tell him I said, "Duh, huh?" You know what you mean.
All right.
Y'all keep them straight up there.
We'll do it.
Right.